Haarken Worldclaimer is also known as the Herald of the Apocalypse. Upon making planetfall, he will thrust his spear into the ground and claim that world for his Lord of Baden, a symbolic act that has seen the doom of many Imperial worlds. Now, in this video, we're going to be taking you for a step-by-step guide on how to paint Haarken Worldclaimer. So when you're ready, let's get started. Now, before we begin painting, the first thing we're going to need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've used Chaos Black, which is perfect for when painting Black Legion. Now, before we do anything else, I'm actually going to coat over using a Baden Black. Now, what this is going to do is the two different finishes when you're using Chaos Black and a Baden Black. So if I make any mistakes later on in this paint guide, I can just tidy up a lot easier if I've coated over with a thin coat of a Baden Black. You'll also notice I've not glued the backpack on as well, which is ideal for getting around all those nitty-gritty areas around the back. So it just makes your life a lot easier. You can glue it on at the end when we're done. So the first thing is applying that Baden Black. So all I'm going to do is get a dollop on my brush. I'm going to thin this down a little bit, so I'm going to use a little bit more water than that. So just slightly thinner. We only need one coat as well, so we're not going to go too mad. All we're going to do is just thinly apply that all over the Chaos Black that we've sprayed. With the Abaddon Black now dry, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to do some highlighting. Now we're going to do the first highlight, and for this one we're using Thunderhawk Blue. Now the idea behind this is to give it like a cold black kind of colour, which will work really well offset against that gold. So I'm using Thunderhawk Blue for this. I'm just going to apply a little bit to my palette. And also at the same time, as well as doing edge highlights, I'm going to do some little chippings as well, just like a little bit of battle damage. So I'll just add a little bit more water to that. And then all I'm going to do is get my brush to a nice point, and we'll start applying it to all those edges. So if we start looking at Haarken, I'll look at his feet first of all. So you've got a couple of like hard edges here. So I'm just going to do some little highlights like so around that. If you do make any mistakes, you can just tidy up with a Baden Black. I'll just move up to his elbow pads as well. Now for the chipping, so I'll just do this line here. You don't have to go mad, you can just do like little notches, like so, and a couple of little dots and stuff. But just look for all those edges that you can see that are clearly like edges of his black armour. Do that across the model. Made a little splodge there, so I'll just tidy that up back up with a little bit of Baden Black as well. And there we are with the Thunderhawk Blue highlights now done. We're going to move on to the final step of the black, and that's to highlight with Fenrisian Grey. Now we're just going to concentrate this on corners and extreme edges. We'll also pick out those chips as well. So I'm just going to grab a little bit, put it on my palette like so, a little touch of water, again just to help it flow, keep it nice and wet and moist on your brush so it doesn't dry up too quickly. Just give it a little twist just to get it to a nice point, and then we'll just start applying those highlights. So what we're going to do here is we're just looking for like corners and stuff. So if I just go in the shoulder, what as they say, shoulder pad, it's more like an elbow pad. Just like pick a little dot there. We're just looking for little areas to pick out. Like I said, also pick out those chips as well. Now the idea when doing any of these extra highlights is you're not trying to cover over the colour you've already done. It's just an extra one on top of it, so it gives it a bit of a gradient. There we are with the black parts of the armour now done. We're going to move on to painting the gold details. Now there's two golds we're going to cover. There's a dirty gold and a bright gold, but we're base coating those both at the same time before we shade them and highlight them. So we're going to start with the trim, which is like a dirty gold, and I'll be using Liberator Gold for this. Now it is a layer paint, so I am going to have to do a couple of coats over the trim, but it will give it that nice washed out kind of dirty kind of grimy look to it. So I'm just adding a little bit of water to it because I don't want it to be too thick when we start applying those coats over. And then we're just going to start picking out the trim. So I'm just spinning to his side there so you can see the shoulder pad. And all I'm going to do is just start painting that on. And like I said, you want to do a couple of thin coats of this. And there we are with the dirty gold now base coated. We're going to move on to picking out the bright gold. And for this, we'll be using Retributor Armor. So I'm just going to get a little bit on my palette, a little touch of water. Now there's a couple of details we're picking out here. There's the spikes, or the tip of the spikes on the jump pack. There's the little sigils just on his shoulder pads. There's one on there, one hidden amongst the skulls. And then, of course, you've got his weapon hilt here, the Eye of Horus. And there we are with the bright gold details now base coated. We're going to move on to applying a shade. Now, for this, we're going to apply Reichen Flesh Shade. I'm going to do it over both areas. Just add a little bit of warmth to those golds. I'm still going to use my small layer brush as well because it just gives me a bit more control. It'll stop me from splodging on those areas that we've been painting black and highlighting. Just add a little touch of water. What we're going to do is start applying that all over. Well, I say all over the gold areas. So around the trim, like so. Be very mindful as well when you're doing this not to let it pull too much. Obviously, it's quite nice in some areas because it pulls around those rivets and gives it a lot of definition. But if it starts to pull in those corners, just use your brush to soak that up. You know, like I said, you want to do both golds. With that shade now dry, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to apply Agrax Earth Shade. Now, we're just going to concentrate this on the dirty gold, which is mainly the trim. And what this will help do is just differentiate it from that bright gold to make it look a bit grimy. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to my palette, like so. We'll start. We'll do exactly the same thing we've just done with the bright gold. And then what we'll start doing is just subtly applying it to around the rivets and stuff, just keeping to those recesses where possible. But again, if it starts to pull, just soak it up with your brush. And there we are with the dirty gold now shaded. We're going to move on to the final step of painting the gold details, and that is to highlight them both using Stormhost Silver. So I'm just going to continue using my small layer brush here. Just going to apply a little bit to my palette, slight touch of water as well, just to help that flow get to a nice point as well. I always find actually by watering the paint down slightly, it just means that it's not, especially if you've got like hot lamps and stuff, it's not drying by the time you get to the model. So adding a little bit of water is actually quite useful. So what we're going to do now is just going to start picking out like things like the rivets and the edges. On the bright gold, you might want to do a little bit more. On the dirty gold, not so much. And there we are, with both the golds now highlighted, we're going to move on to the next step, which is paint the dirty metal. Now for this, we're going to start with Lead Belcher. We're going to shade it with Agrax Earthshade, just to give it that kind of dirty tone. Then we're going to darken that down with Norn Oil, and we'll finish off with a highlight of Stormhost Silver. So first of all, let's get that Lead Belcher on. Just going to apply a little bit to my palette. And again, just a little touch of water, just to help it with the smoothness and all that. And then we'll start picking that. I'll start on the blade first. You've got the blade itself, and then the little bit at the back. The little stabby thing at the end. With all those silver details picked out with Lead Belcher, we're now going to shade them with Agrax Earth Shade. What we're trying to do here is just make all that metal look a little bit dirty, tarnished and old. So you want to apply this all over all the silver areas you've just done. With the Agrax Earth Shade now dry, I'm going to use Norn Oil. I'm just going to keep this to like some of the deeper recesses, some of the edges, like where there's other bits attached to it, like around the hilt here. If you get around the front here, you've got some pipes, so actually just run it into those cracks and just where the pipes meet the power armor, to give it some nice transition and a bit of a blendy effect. When you've got the claws, I'm just going to keep it to the bottom of the claws, not the tips. Once the shade's completely dry, we're now going to use Stormhost Silver. We're going to start edge highlighting all the metal details. So on the blade, I'm just going to use the edge of the brush like so, just to get a nice hard edge like that. And there'll be other areas like some of the pipes and stuff where you've got like, you want to do some scratches. So what we can do here is actually just thin that paint down a bit and then just run our brush, just give it a couple of little thin strokes like that, just to give it a little bit of a scratchy, dented kind of effect. So obviously this guy's seen a lot of war. With the dirty metal details now done, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to start painting the bone details. Now for this, we're going to start rack our flesh, we're then going to shade with Seraphim CP, just to give it a bit of a yellowy tone. We're then going to use Agrax Earth Shade just in some of the deeper recesses. We'll then tidy back up, we'll rack our flesh, and then we'll pick out the final highlights using Pally Witch Flesh. Now there's quite a few skulls on this guy, so some on his backpack and some on his actual belt. So what I'm going to do is just start picking out those to start off with. And on his shoulder pad, he's got some sculpted detail as well, so we'll do that as well. So let's just start doing those skulls. So he's got a few on his belt just here. Now, the top one here, we're going to be painting in rack off. This one, we're going to leave because we're going to do that later on. And that's going to be more like a flayed skull or like a demonic skull. So do the other two after that. And remember, you might need to do two thin coats of this. With those bone details now base coated, we're going to shade them with Seraphim Sepia. Now I'm going to be applying this all over those bone details. So it's a full wash or shade. Bear in mind, obviously, you don't want it to pull too much in some of those recesses, so if it does get quite heavy, just use your brush to soak it up. Once the Seraphim CP is dry, we're now going to use Agrax Earth Shade, and we're going to keep this just to some of those deeper recesses of the bone areas. So if I look right where his chest plate is, you've got like the skull details. Just move around to where his shoulder pad is. You've also got the 8-pointed star, so I'm just going to concentrate that around the actual star itself, just to give it some more definition. And on the skulls, you just want to just sink it in to where those eye sockets are. Like so. Once that shade's completely dry, we're now going to use Rack Our Flesh again, and we're going to start tidying up with this. Now, in some places, it's more like an edge highlight. In others, like the actual skulls themselves, around the top where the cranium is, we'll just do more of a layer. But then when you start getting around the eye sockets, we want to treat that more like an edge highlight. So just be careful and just pick those areas out where you really want the Rack Our Flesh to stand out the most. With the tidy up now done, we're just going to edge highlight all those bone details with Pallid Witch Flesh. Again, just concentrate us on the very edges where the light's probably going to catch it. If you do make any mistakes, you can always tidy back up using Rack Our Flesh. With all the bone details now done, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to paint the skin, which is just basically the top of his head. Now, for this, we're going to start with Rakar flesh. We're then going to shade with Rakan flesh shade. We'll follow that with Caribou Crimson just to pick out some of the scar details on his head. And finally, we'll highlight with Pallid Witch flesh. So first of all, we're just going to grab that Rakar flesh out of the pot, apply a little bit to the palette, a little touch of water, get to a nice point, and we'll start painting it. So like I said, it's just the very top of his head. It's just like his skull showing. Now you could do this at the same time you do the bone. We've just done it separately just so it's easy to identify what areas need doing. You might want to do a couple of coats of this as well. With the skin now base coated, we're going to add some Reichland flesh shade. What this will do, we'll just add a bit of warmth to that colour. Once the Reichland flesh shade's dry, we're now going to apply Caribou Crimson to the scar details on his head. Now he's got three scars, one running either side near his brows and one running right down the middle. I'd also recommend just running some of that Caribou Crimson just around where his skull mask is as well, just to give it like a kind of a sore feel to it. And finally, we're going to highlight that skin using Pallid Witch flesh. Now on the scars themselves, I'm just going to gently dot just to give that old kind of scar tissue kind of feel to it. So I'm just going to dot that up along there. You'll be able to see it because it'll protrude out. However, where his skull is, or scalp, what I'm going to do is slightly thin it down and run Pallid Witch on the top. And when it's dry, you will see some of that Rakar flesh kind of almost showing through the Pallid Witch because it's thinned down slightly. And there we are, with the skin now done, we're going to move on to the next detail, which is to paint the dark red. So this is the weapon half, the flayed skull, and there's also some detailing on his left greave as well. So I'm going to be using corn red for this, so I'm just going to apply a little bit to my palette, like so, and get a little bit of water. What I'll do is just spin that around until I get a nice point, like so, and then we'll start painting. So like I say, the weapon half, I'm just going to be painting that all corn red, but the flayed skull is just here. I say flayed skull, it could also be a demonic skull. It could be anything. It could be whatever you want it to be. But it's going to be red regardless. And there we are with those red details now base coated. What we're going to do now is move on to applying a shade of Norn oil. Now this will really darken down those colours, give it that really dark burgundy kind of feel. If you do feel the need to tidy up after, you can just do a little bit of corn red after that. So I'm just going to get some on my brush like so, spin it around a tad. There we are, get a nice point to it, and then we'll start applying it. I'll start applying it to actually the skull detail, like so. So I'll just apply that over, let it sink to those recesses so it really darkens down. Now the thing on his greave, so this like skull design here, what you can do is just to pull a little bit more around the edges, and that will give it a nice blend between the black and the red. You can always do a couple of coats just to increase that blend if you need to. With the Norn oil now dry, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to highlight, and we're going to use Wazdaka red for this. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to my palette again. Again, I'm going to continue using my small layer brush. I'll just get a nice point to the brush like so, and then we'll start picking it out. Now there's a couple of things to bear in mind. So when you're doing the actual skull face, I'm just going to like pick out just edges and corners, mainly around like the eye sockets and any kind of protruding kind of spiky bits. Don't forget the teeth as well. And also on the haft, I'm just going to make sure I get a nice point to my brush. So you've got obviously like the banding that goes across it. So what we're going to do is I'm just going to pick out one side of the banding on every strap like so. We need to do this on both sides, but it's a general idea, just a little streak like that. And there we are with that highlight done. We're now going to move on to the final stage, which is to highlight with Cadian flesh tone. What this will do is it'll give a bit of warmth to that dark red, but without it looking too pinky. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to my palette. A little dollop of water as well. A nice point to my brush. And this is just for extreme highlights now, so we're not going to go like too mad doing every single part. So on the skull itself, again, just like little corners, like around the jaw, and the cheekbones and stuff, and the nose and the teeth. Oops. Did a little bit too much there, but that's fine. If you do make any mistakes, you can always tidy up. What on his actual weapon haft, you're going to have to be obviously a little bit tidier or thinner when you do these highlights. So just a little bit here and there, just on the raised parts. You don't have to do every part of the banding. And there we are with the dark red details now done. We're going to move on to painting the bright red details. This is things like his eye lenses, the loincloth, also the fiery detail on his spear as well. So we're going to start off with Mephiston red. We're then going to shade like things like the loincloth, but not the fiery effect on his spear. But we're shading this with Aggretsu shade. We'll then pick out a Wild Rider red and finally using Fire Dragon bright. So for the most part, I'm going to be using a small layer brush for this with a little bit of water. However, when I do the glowing runes on his spear, what we'll do is we'll just use a medium base brush and we'll start like stabbing it on a tad. So what I'm going to do is just pick out the loincloth here. So I'm just coating that all over with Mephiston red, like so. Like I said, there's like a couple of little tubes in his eyes and stuff, so make sure you get a nice pointy brush when you do that. However, I'm just going to quickly move down to using the base brush. So I'm just going to stab that into the actual paint. What we're going to do is going to move on to the spear, like so. And I'm just going to stab like that. Now, it might look a bit messy to start off with, but what I'm going to do in a second is just run my finger around those edges a little bit. Just keep stabbing. Mephiston Red now base coated. We're going to start applying Agrax Surfshade to those areas we've just done. So that's the loincloth, the little tube under his armpit, but we won't be doing it on the actual spear. We're leaving that as it is. But just mainly the loincloth we're doing. With the shade now dry, we're going to use Wild Rider Red just to pick out some of those fine highlights on the cloth. We'll do that on the eyes as well, and the little tube just under his armpit. However, when we come to doing the actual cursed spear, I'm just doing a little couple of little bits there like that. We're just going to try and pick out those little runes just around the edges there. So you can also just do the bit down the middle of the spear. So just pick around those runes. You don't have to be too neat because it's almost like we're trying to do a glow effect. I'm not trying to do an edge highlight here. Just picking them around. And if you do go into those recesses of the runes, you can just drop some Angrax Earthshade back inside. That'll give it some definition. Finally, we're going to finish off those red details using Fire Dragon Bright. So on the Cursed Spear, what I'm going to do now is just be a little bit neat around those runes and then just use Fire Dragon Bright just to emphasise, give it more of a hot, glowy kind of effect. So just gently just picking out those edges. Again, if you're making a mistake, you can just use the previous colour to try and tidy up. And also on his cloth and like eyes and stuff like that, again, we're just doing real fine highlights here. So nothing too special. And there we are with those bright red details now done. We're going to move on to the final step, which is to paint the dead Space Marine on his base. Now, I'd recommend painting the same colour scheme of your regular opponents, because when you bring them on the battlefield, it will give them something to focus on and get quite annoyed by. Now, I'm going to personally paint this as an Ultramarine, because there's a couple of people in the studio that collect those armies, so I know they'll have fun seeing that guy dead on his base. So the colours we're going to be starting off with, we'll be using a Crag Blue. I'm going to pick out the gold trim using Retributor Armour. I'm going to shade all over with Angrax Surfshade because it'll give it a dirty, grimy look. And we'll finish off with a highlight of Khalgar Blue. So first of all, let's get some of my Crag Blue on my brush. Just apply a little bit there and a little bit of water as well. And we'll just start picking it out. So it's, obviously, it doesn't look very happy. He's got a massive, great big piece of metal sticking out of his chest as well. So I'm just going to coat my Crag Blue all over his armour. With the power armor now base coated, we're going to move on to picking out the gold trim and the eagle. For this, we're using Retributor armor. So you might want to do a couple of coats of this. We'll just get that on, and then we'll be ready to do the shade and make him look all dirty and grimy. With the gold now applied, we're going to shade all over with Agrax Earthshade. So give him a real subdued, battered look. Once the Agrax Earthshade is thoroughly dry, we're now ready to start highlighting. Now for this, I'm going to be using some Khalgar Blue just on the edges. I'm not going to do every edge. I'm just going to pick little edges here and there. You could dry brush this if you want the body to look like it's been there a lot longer, so it'll give it more of a weathered look. I'm just going to use a couple of little edges just to pick out. But I'm not going to go too mad because he's dead. We don't want to put too much effort on him. And remember, when you've done this, to base the model in the colour scheme of your army. With the model now painted and based, Haarken Worldclaimer is ready to head off and claim some worlds in the name of Abaddon the Despoiler. Now, there are a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, because we use Chaos Black Spray to represent, obviously, doing the black armour, it's always worth base coating with Abaddon Black, just in case you make any mistakes. Secondly, when doing any edge highlighting, always try and get your brush to a nice point, thin that paint down a bit as well, just because it will flow better, and take your time as well, don't try and rush it. And lastly, when doing any shading, try not to overload your brush too much with shade, and if it does pull in some of those areas, just soak it up. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own Haarken Worldclaimer, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.